Hello, everybody, and welcome. Hello to our speaker. Hello to everyone. This is Nellie Deutsch, and I'm not the speaker. I will be adding my voice and chat from time to time, so you can see it's Nellie. In the chat box, I'll be using pink. Okay, so pink will be Nellie writing and not anyone else. All right, our speaker is right here. His name is Ramon, and Ramon is from Spain. He's going to show us, demonstrate how you can add quizzes to Moodle, but not only to Moodle, but we'll focus on Moodle today. And I think this is really important because a lot of us are asking how we can make the most of the quiz plugin on Moodle. And one of the questions that I have is about paragraphs. I got lots of questions from universities that want to know how they can make the most of the quizzes for different purposes. So thank you everyone for joining. If you could just add in the chat, we're going to get started so that we don't lose any time and we can make the most. So Ramon, thank you for joining us today, and I'll let you take over. All right, so thank you, Ramon.
No one said anything against it. I guess you're getting me. So I will try to introduce you to what is this global solution for national education. As Nellie was saying, we have a solution for me. We also have solutions for Sakai, Blackboard, JazzLearn, Canvas, and other learning management systems. I would say that our solution for me is the most advanced one, and the one that we use in the entire field. So that's, I think that's going to be the most appropriate from our market. Well, I'd like to move it a little bit faster and go into the demonstration. Online calculator and online questionnaires, what we call value quizzes. Okay. For you to have an idea, we try to give all these tools really well integrated into the platform. We can offer the service to be hosted in our own server, so you can host it in your own server in the platform. Okay. And of course we try to give you the customer service and we have to practice. And let's go to the details. So what you're seeing here is our designator. Yes, so our designator is basically a JavaScript solution. That means that it works on tablet devices.
Thank you very much. Okay, thank you very much. If no one says anything against it, I guess you're hearing me. So I will try to introduce you to why is it a global solution for mathematics education. As Nellie was saying, we have a solution for Moodle. We also have solutions for Sakai, Blackboard, Desire to Learn, Canvas, and many other learning management systems. To be very precise, I would say that our solution for Moodle is the most advanced one, and the one that includes most of our tools. So that's, I think that you're going to get the most of what we get from our math book. Okay. So I'll try to move it a little bit faster and go into the demonstration quite fast. So as I was saying, we try to make it a full solution for mathematics education, including an equationator, an interactive online calculator, and online questionnaires, what we call value quizzes. Okay. For you to have an idea, we try to give all these tools really well integrated into the platform. We can offer the service to be hosted in our own server, so you can host it in your own server, so no problem. Okay. And of course, we try to give you a good customer service, and we have very proactive support
And the
team.
business
Yeah.
component, business
Okay,
component.
and let's go into the details. So
Another
what you're seeing here is our coordinator.
it is basically an
Yes,
upgrade
so
existing
our coordinator is basically a JavaScript solution.
And
that means that it works on tablet devices.
Let me just
obviously we have support for iPad and Firefox and Chrome in all devices, and sometimes if you are using a Galaxy with a strange browser, we cannot guarantee that works there. Okay, but well, it's basically going to work in any tablet device that we want it to work, and we can make the effort work. Yeah. Okay. If there are any questions, I will try to answer them later on. As I was saying, the editor is a visual editor, so it's what you see is what you get. We use MathML as a standard notation to edit the mathematics. As you saw in the screenshot, there is some LaTeX support as well. I can go into details if someone needs that. Okay, and then that's basically all. We also have a good feature in terms of accessibility. Okay, so if you are interested in the accessibility of the mathematical content, we have good solutions here. Okay, for the CAS, that's computer algebra system, it's basically an online calculator used at K-12 high schools and first years of the university. You can see it here. We have two-dimensional graphics, three-dimensional graphics, interactive things. Well, it's a regular online calculator. Yeah, I won't make too much of a point here. Okay, as I was saying, covering the curriculum in secondary and then finally the quizzes component. Quizzes component is it's not a standalone solution. It is basically an upgrade to the existing quizzes mode in Moodle. And I think the best thing that we can do is we try to go inside. Let me just point out a couple of things. So what we're doing here is a good integration with Moodle to create, first of all, random variables and graphics, so you can have.
Yeah, that's why I left my mic on. Yes, we can see it, Ramon.
In your quizzes. That is narrow, so Moodle has possibility to have
right.
Random,
no, you can. Actually, you can. It's at the bottom left.
And
chat may drop to the bottom
so
left. You can
have.
Pop it up.
Automatic,
but then we would see it too, and that might interfere.
That you, can get.
You can minimize the chat, make it wider or narrower.
Obviously, the questionnaire is available for students to answer. And
so
finally,
you can put it on the side.
Have,
yeah, there it is. That's right. You can put it on the side so it doesn't
the
disturb
looks,
the
looks nice.
The screen.
And if it's broken, we can. Well, the student will have a message saying you should not be sending this email, so this formula, because it's really wrong. Okay. And I think I'm going to.
There,
make
I put mine.
Into,
you can make it. You can make it narrower. If you
so
go to the
I'll
sides, you can kind of bring it.
Where is it from?
Make it narrower. Than it is, but yeah,
okay.
You can. Yeah, if you go to the sides, you can yeah, exactly
then,
just merit, make it as narrow as you wish, yeah, and then just put it on the side.
Not with wireless, not with wireless. Maybe. Okay, so I will go now into a demo site for Moodle. That's
okay.
I wrote it in the chat window. It's our Moodle 2 demo site.
Okay,
I would
so
like to share my screen.
I'm going to log in.
It should be happening.
Orange button saying login feature.
In a few seconds.
It's going to log me in as an English feature, so everybody is going to see text.
Okay. So you should be seeing my screen.
Now,
if no one says,
I'll
not
really,
I believe you're seeing it. And I'm going into this. I'll talk. Neil, can you confirm that you are all seeing my screen?
Okay.
Okay, perfect. So I will not be able to see the chat window, I guess. So if there is anything.
So that's a regular Moodle page. We'll have components that have been produced as well. What you're seeing here are basically images. Okay, you can inspect the elements. You will see it is an image. Okay. So how
okay.
Do you create
like
when we go to edit the page?
Okay, I'll try.
You simply have in the Moodle toolbar, you have a couple of new icons.
Okay, yes, it's not obvious how to, it's not obvious to me how to see that. So
So here it is.
I'm
So
trying to.
if I want to create a formula, I'm going to press the square root button. And I can create a kind of formula.
Okay.
If I accept the button, then the formula is there. If I want to,
that's the most narrow thing you can bring. Okay, I'll simply okay. I'll try to do it. Sorry. Okay, and I'm getting it to work. Okay, perfect. So hopefully it works. Okay, so I'm going to log in with this orange button saying "Log in teacher." That is going to log me in as an English teacher, so everybody's going to see text in English, hopefully. And now I'll show you very briefly in 5-10 minutes how the editor works and then the calculator, so you have an idea, and then we'll move into the business stuff. Okay, because otherwise it's a little bit awkward to see how everything works. Okay, so I go to this editor course. Here we can see how the editor works, but that's a regular Moodle page. Where we have some formulas that have been produced with Wireless. What you're seeing here are basically images. Okay, if I inspect the element, you will see that it is an image. Okay. So how did you create that? When we go to edit the page, we simply have in the Moodle toolbar, we have a couple of icons. Give it a few seconds to load. Okay, so here it is. So if I want to create a formula, I can simply press the square root button and I can create some kind of formula. If I accept the button, then the formula is there. Okay. If I want to edit an existing formula, I can simply double click on it, and the new formula appears, and we can change it. So that's how the equation works. We were speaking before about this LaTeX support. So some. Okay. So, well, it looks like you're not seeing the chat. Window, but well, I'm trying to read the chat, so if anything appears, I will try to answer. Okay, so here, if you want to have some LaTeX support, we are seeing basically the same thing again, web page with an image as a formula. If I edit we will see now that the LaTeX code is there. I know if many people are familiar with LaTeX in the chat, but basically LaTeX is a scripting language to create math formulas. Okay, let's say it's a little bit ugly, but it's what we all have here. So if you create a here slanted bar frac 1 2. Okay, looks like it's changing slowly. Somewhat dumb says. Okay, I'll try to make things as low so things appear from time to time. So basically, when you have the LaTeX code inside of the double dollars, we can create a fraction, sorry, a formula. I'm changing this formula now very simply, just by saying x plus fraction 1, 2. And if I save and display that content, you will be seeing. Okay. So now we have this formula here. Okay. So that there is some LaTeX support. Okay. We can go back to the other courses.
But apart from that, I would say that it's possible to use it on the elementary level.
But you may have seen is a JavaApplet solution right now that brings a lot of problems. That is the same kind of problem that the default equation editor in Moodle has. So, well, you may be seeing a section of work in my screen saying represent a fraction of polynomials, and then there is a nice graphic appearing. Okay. This is well, just an example of what the calculator can do. So you can basically embed math calculations inside Moodle. And then I would go for the quizzes tool. So what do we have here? So as I said, we have here, I'm going to go to the question bank, and I'm sure you heard what. So in the question bank here. There's a question from Genevieve regarding the level. So she sees a lot of secondary level formulas, and can it work on elementary level? To be honest, I would say that most of our customers are from secondary and university level, not so many from elementary. But it's possible to use it. There is one thing that we need to be doing in the next few months that will help the elementary level. That's like some kind of long division that's simply being used, and that will be included for the next school year. But apart from that, I would say that it's possible to use it on elementary level, but obviously it's not so frequent. Okay. We also have you could also like determine a different toolbar for elementary level. Okay. So I'll go back to the quizzes module. So basically now this is the module, the question bank. When I try to create a new question, you see that there is a new kind of question called Math and Science by Wiley. So here is where we store all the new kind of questions that we have. When you press this button, other questions appear. So we have created basically a short answer with mathematics, a true-false answer with mathematics, a multiple choice answer with mathematics, everything. So all the regular Moodle questions have been reproduced with Moodle, because sometimes when you have like, you have a very simple true-false question, but you want to automatically, to randomize the question, well, you need the mathematics there. And when you have a short answer, you can automatically grade it. And when you have a matching, you sometimes want to generate random parameters there and so on. So you really can do mathematics in all those kinds of questions. Okay. So I'll simply go and visit the first example. This question is answer simplified. I'm going to first of all show the question to see how it works. So imagine a very simple question: calculate the division of 1/2 and 1/4. And simplify the answer. Let's try to answer something that is text. Okay, the correct answer is 3/4. And I submit a finished question. And the system is telling me it's correct. Okay, but what happens if, for example, I answer something like this? I know the rules of adding fractions, so I say 1 times 2 divided by 2 times 2 plus 1 divided by 4. Okay, that is a good answer. Okay, but it's obviously not simplified as we asked in the question. And if I try to. I need to start again. I answer this again. I answer 1 times 2, 2 times 2, plus 1/4. So that is the correct answer. But when I submit and finish,
We have to put
I get, okay,
right to left.
you had to simplify the answer,
Exactly.
my friend, because that's what it says like that. Okay, how did you get this to happen?
So simply,
well, let's go to see the inside of the question. I go to the, I go to this question, and
the validation rules that we display here are, well, this is like a long list of what it has, and we have
let's give it a few seconds.
Can be a fraction, fraction.
Okay. Regarding the Japanese question, we don't have so we have Japanese for the equation, I believe. We don't have Japanese for quizzes, but that's something that we could really solve quite fast. Okay? So, here is the question, calculate the addition of 1/2 and 1/4. That looks very much like a regular Moodle question, okay? But suddenly, in the answer, instead of having like a
3 by 4,
well, we have this answer being 3 by 4 and then this item. So it's here we're saying if the answer is 3 by 4 and the answer is mathematically equal to the right answer and it's simplified, we will give 100% of the grading. If the answer is correct, 3 by 4, but it's not simplified, we will only give 20% of the grading. Okay. Sorry, I have to say in the chat we have support for Arabic and Hebrew. In fact, so I will go back to later. We have support for right to left languages. In fact, so okay. So 3 by 4 simplified answer, you get 100% of the grading. So how we get this? So we get into the studio where we determine the student answer. So the correct answer is 3 by 4. The validation rules that we play here are well, this is like a long list of what we have.
We have
and we have the answer can be formula, can be a fraction, mixed fraction, a physical unit, something like this. And then you have like a little list of the properties that the answer has to fulfill. In this case, we're saying that the answer must be simplified. Okay? So what we're doing is saying, okay, sorry, I changed that. The answer is a general answer, math formula, being simplified. Okay? And then the second answer, 3 by 4, is simply if someone answers something mathematically equal to 3 by 4, he will get a 20% of the answer. In the previous answer that we were doing, I was giving a right answer. It was mathematically equal to the right answer, but it was not simplified. That's what I was. Well, that's why I only got 20%. Okay. So.
I submit as soon as that answer,
I'm going to say,
but obviously, again, you're going to say, well, that you need to simplify.
Go back and see the question again.
Okay. So I can go and I'll be just to you.
So you see that if I answer, for example, something very stupid, I
just
1 divided by 2 plus 1 divided by 4. And I submit that it is again a right answer because it's obviously the answer is correct, but it's not simplified. So I'm getting
the first answer really is
okay.
X minus so, 1 times x plus 1 times square.
That's a very simple example.
Simplified and
okay. We have some more sophisticated examples.
The answer is only factorized, which was the case before. It gave me 20%, 80%.
Factorized is polynomial.
And that's it.
And
okay.
I have to guess what is
we can do more things because
the polynomial
depending on the
I know one of those is square, but I can't remember which one.
Okay. So we're having here I've shown you very two
okay. So that was an incorrect answer.
Mathematical evaluation. Okay. We are covering
if I
more and more every
write
day.
a good one.
Might be very wide, but we can do quite a lot of master synthesis solutions. Okay. The other,
for example, this minus one. So right answer is x plus 1 times x plus 1. Okay, that is your correct answer. But I can do some things like that. Put some extra spaces, put some stupid plus symbols here, and then a couple of minus symbols here that are basically the same answer. This is mathematically equivalent answer, but it's, in, but it's obviously not simplified. If I submit and finish that answer, it's going to say it's correct. But obviously, again, it's going to say, well, but you need to simplify it.
I get different numbers. Yeah. Okay, so every time we see question, we get different
numbers. Okay. So I can go and see how this was created.
From the system.
Okay. Okay. I go to see how this was created. We can sit here. So basically, we have a question, factorized polynomial or whatever, and then the first answer to it is x minus 1 times x plus 1 to the square, and we want the answer to be simplified and factorized, we'll give you 100% of the case. If the answer is only factorized, which was my case before, he gave me 20%, 80% of the grade, and that's it. Okay? We can do more things.
So we can
give some specific feedback depending on the number of whatever, the kind of answer, whatever.
Here, the first answer.
Okay. So we're having here, I've shown you very two simple examples of mathematical evaluation. We are covering more and more every day. Obviously, mathematics is very wide, but we can do quite a lot of math questions with this. Okay. The other part that we are doing and that is interesting is the randomization of the questions. Okay, so I'm going to show you now the same question that we were seeing the first one, so this addition of fractions. This time the question is very similar, but you see that numbers have changed. If I can answer something stupid.
So here we have
this is obviously incorrect.
I hope that you are all seeing it.
If I start again this
question, a little algorithm. So we are creating a number of p that is basically
I get different numbers. Yeah. Okay, so every time we see question, we get different numbers
randomly
from
the region. Then we create a number
from the system,
which is a function number randomly generated. In this case, there is something very mathematical saying the denominator of q must be different to the denominator
of q. I'll check and see how that works.
The question a little bit more interesting. It is important to say that
first time, instead of having instead of having like
for the ones who are
a fixed wording, we have calculated the addition of sharp p and sharp q. That means at some point there is an algorithm saying the value of p and the value of q, so we can substitute them when we see the question. Here the first answer, the solution is simply solution. We want the answer to be simplified. And the second answer to the question is solution again, and we want the answer to be mathematically equal. Someone has probably been playing with this question because it's really explained at this point. And well, when I go to see the solution, and go to so we have this correct answer. So the correct answer is solution. In the validation that we had before, we have the same thing, so we want the answer to be simplified. Okay, and then we have this variables tab where we can create the algorithms. Okay, so here we have, I hope that you are all seeing it, a little algorithm. So we are creating a number p that is basically a fraction number, okay, randomly generated. Then we create a number q, which is a function number, randomly generated. In this case, there is something very mathematical saying the denominator of q must be different to the denominator of p. That This is
Okay.
just to make the
There's
question
also
a little bit
Spain
more
too.
interesting.
And
It is important to say that
Portugal.
since while this is a very
Portugal is Portugal,
mathematical-oriented
right? Because the answer is
stuff,
simplified and it's
this kind of notation is something that for the ones who are also math-oriented or math teachers or science teachers, that is something reasonable.
Portugal
So it's quite simple
and
or
achievable
it's
after
relatively
sitting
easy
simplified.
for math people to understand
How
what
much
the
is
algorithm is doing.
11
Okay,
divided
I
by
then have
3?
the solution
Google
is
would
just
say
P and Q. This is in
6.1.
the yellow box we are seeing, let's say the
So let's go
algorithm.
back here.
Then outside the yellow box we can
What
check
will happen if someone
what
says
will happen every
0.11?
time we have
And then
this
3.
quiz. So numbers will be changing.
It will say
And
that
if
the answer
we
is correct and it's simplified.
press the calculation button several
Because
times, we
obviously
see
we are testing
how that is
the answer from a
changing.
mathematical point of view.
Okay?
So
So
we never said that we wanted the answer to be a
it's
fraction
quite
of 50
easy in
cents.
terms
We
of
wanted the answer to be
the author of the
magnitude.
question to validate that the parameters
So
are changing as he wants
if someone answers
without having to go back to
0.61,
Moodle
of course
and run the
he is
question several
correct
times.
answer.
You're
If
more or less
he
autonomous
wants the answer, for
inside
example,
these
not to be to be a fraction form, he can
worries
go
too.
into the validation
Okay?
step again
And there is one
to
more
look for
option,
this.
so you
So
can
there is
really
a point where we
preview
say, I want the
and say,
answer to
okay,
have a fraction
what
form.
will happen if a
And
student
now here,
answers, so the right answer to this question is 11
divided by the
divided by
distance,
18. What will
this
happen if someone
0.61
answers
is not anymore a right
1
answer.
plus
Because
divided by
me, as an
18?
author, I
I
said
can test
the
this.
answer had to be a fraction.
And so, okay,
Okay?
the answer will be
I'm not
incorrect
sure
because
if
the
that
answer is
was
not
clear to
simplified.
everybody. Hopefully
Okay.
it was.
What will happen if someone
This
answers
very silent
11.0
environment
divided by
for me
18?
to get the idea of how people are feeling about
I
this.
test
But
this.
I
Well,
guess that's
this one is
more
going
or
to be
less
correct
getting. Okay,
because
at least
the answer is
someone
simplified
got
and
it.
it's okay.
So I'm
Okay.
happy with that. Okay, so
I will
that's right. We have
do
this
something
validation
by
area where
saying
we
now
can
I go
see
to
the
Google.
precise structure.
I go to Google
What kind of a structure do you want for the answer?
and ask Google
And
very stupid thing like
you can be quite precise there. Okay?
how much is
So
11
I would
divided by 18?
finally go
And Google will say
to see some other examples.
6.11. Okay, so let's go back here. What will happen if someone says 0.611? And I
Well,
test
we
this.
tried to show you this.
It will say that the answer is correct and it's simplified.
It's a good one again.
Okay, because obviously we are testing the
What
answer
would you
from a
do
mathematical
for
point of view.
polynomial?
So
Given that three
we
options,
never said that we wanted the
yes.
answer to be a fraction. We
I was
simply said
saying
that we
before,
wanted the answer to
we
be
can do
mathematically equivalent.
open
Okay,
closed answers
so
in Moodle, but sometimes
if someone answers
here we haven't got
6
multiple choice
point one
questions.
one, it's going to
These are
say it's
multiple
a
choice
correct
questions
answer.
produced by
Okay,
Wiley because
if you
sometimes
want the answer, for example, not to be or to be a fraction form, I
interesting
can go into the
to
validation
use
tab
it
again.
randomly. Okay, so
Look
here,
for
what
this.
is the
So
degree
there
of
is a point where you
polynomial?
say, I want
I
the
would
answer to
say
have
if
a
I say
fraction form.
zero, which I know
And
to be
now
one,
here,
I will get some feedback saying you have chosen the constant term.
if I
Or
test this,
if I answer
zero point six one
constant,
one is not
I get.
anymore a right answer because me as an author, I said the answer had to be a
But if there's
fraction.
a different polynomial,
Okay?
I will simply
I'm not
check
sure
that
if that was
somehow
clear to everybody.
to
Hopefully, it
get
was.
the right answer. Okay, I'll go and
This
see
very
how well
silent
this answers
environment is difficult
if
for
it's
me
for you
to get the idea of
to
how people are feeling about this. But I guess that you are more or less getting okay. At least Tom and Jenny got it. So I'm happy with that. Okay, so as I said, we have this validation area where we can be very precise of structure. What kind of a structure do you want for the answer? And
So the answer
you can be quite precise there. Okay,
as we
so
see, it
I
looks very
would
much like a regular
finally go
multiple choice question in Moodle.
to see
Here, again,
some
the
other
question text
examples.
is slightly different. So what is the degree of the following
Okay,
start
give
with this?
me.
So
Okay.
following polynomial start with this. And then in the answer,
So I'll try to
what
show
would happen
you
for
this.
choice one, we have variable B.
This is a good one again.
For choice two, we have variable C. For choice
So,
three, we have variable
what is the
I.
degree of a polynomial?
Okay.
Here we have three options. Okay,
So
I was saying
if I
before,
go into the
we can
algorithm,
do
what
open short answers
I can see
in
the
Moodle,
closed
but
variables.
sometimes here we have an example of multiple
Short
choice
answers.
question. This is a multiple choice question produced by Wiris because sometimes
It's using the options there, and for the variables,
it's
that's
interesting
a little algorithm,
to use it
and
randomly.
then
Okay, so here, what is the degree of the following
we have
polynomial? I would say, if I say
some
it's zero,
polynomial,
which I
or a
know
little
is
function
incorrect,
that is
I will get
generating
some
a
feedback saying
name
you have
of some
chosen the
function,
constant term of the polynomial.
then
If I
the
answer,
degree of the polynomial is p.
if I start again,
And p is
okay, it's obviously a
independent
different polynomial. I will simply
term of
check the right
the
answer now,
highest
and you'll get the right answer. Okay,
element
I'll
if
go and
you're
see how was
thinking
this produced,
couple of words,
so
int,
it's
like the number
easier for
first
you
of the
to
biggest
understand how it works.
number. So you may, as a student,
It's here.
be confused between those two numbers. And I is independent term here. Okay, and then we'll repeat. So we create a polynomial with five elements. I can create it with, let's say, with three elements this time, where D is different
Okay,
from C, and
so
D
this
is
is
different from I, and C is different from I,
as
so
we
that we
see,
never get
it looks very much like a
B, C, and I
regular
equal.
multiple choice question
Okay,
in Moodle.
because if we get B, C, and I
Here
equal,
again,
then
the
students
question
won't have a
text
problem
is
because we
slightly
will see the
different.
first
What is the
word.
degree of the
Okay,
following
determine
sharp P?
the
So
cortices of
following
the
polynomial
polynomial,
sharp
and
P,
suddenly two number
and
fives
then
appear,
in the
and just to know
answers,
which number five is the
we
right
simply
number,
have for
because
choice one
Moodle is
we
not
have
like
variable D.
removing
For
the
choice two,
repeated
we
answer.
have
So
variable
we have to
C,
remove the
and for
repeated answer
choice
here
three, we have
before
variable I.
producing repeated answer.
Okay.
Okay. So now since I've changed, I am
So
only creating three
if
elements.
I go into
The
the
polynomials
algorithm
are every time
at the beginning,
shorter than before.
I can see that those variables,
So it's,
so
well,
the correct answer
simply shorter.
is,
And as I said,
is in
those
the
variables
options
here,
there,
B, C,
and
and
for the
I, are the
variables
ones
we
that we
have
use
a little algorithm.
outside for the answer. So
And
if the student answers
we
B, we'll give him 100%
can, so we have
credit.
a
If the student answers C, we'll
polynomial,
say, you have chosen
so a
the
little function
cortices
that is generating an element of a
So
polynomial,
this is an example that is
then
of
the
our
degree of the
understanding
polynomial is p,
relatively easy to produce math questions
and
with Wiley too.
c is the
And
independent
then just to finish, I'd like you to
term
look
of
at
the highest
graphics
element.
here.
So here
So
in the example
we're
that we were
creating
seeing,
a
it's like
system
the number in front of the biggest
where
number. So you may, as a student, be confused between those two numbers,
I guess we can
and
see
I
how.
is independent term here.
So we can see how
Okay,
this
and
works
then we'll repeat.
for C.
So we
So
create a polynomial
here
with
we have
five elements. I can
polynomial,
create it
whatever
with,
has
let's
roots,
say,
minus 4 and 5, which
with
is
three elements this
which is
time,
the
where
following corresponds to the
D
graphics.
is different
And
from
you have three
C,
different
and
functions
D
that
is
are
different
called
from I,
n,
and C is different from I,
where I'm
so that
assuming
we never get
you see that the
D,
right
C, and
answer
I equal.
is
Okay?
first
Because
one
if we get
and
D, C, and I equal,
then
then student may have a problem because he may see a question where it says, okay, determine
probably right.
the coefficient of the polynomial, and suddenly two number fives appear, and he doesn't know which number five is the right number five,
I was thinking of
because Moodle is not
this.
like
Obviously, we're
removing
mixing
the
everything
repeated
together
answers.
to get it
So we
right.
have to remove the
I want
repeated
to show you
answers
how it
here
works.
before
So,
producing repeated answers.
polynomial P
Okay?
has roots A and B.
So now, since I've changed, I am only
For the
creating
graphics,
three elements.
you simply
The
say
polynomials are every time shorter than
first
before.
one is
Okay?
something called plotter
So
1,
it's,
choice 2 is
well,
plotter 2,
it's simply
choice 3
shorter.
is simply plotter 3.
Okay? And as I said, those
And
variables here,
flowers,
D, C, and I, are the
all
ones that are
appear.
used outside for the answer. So if the student answers D,
Well,
we will
you
give
can
him
just
100% of the
put
grade. The
some
student answers
random
C,
variable
we'll say, you have chosen the leading coefficient,
anticipation of the
and
polynomial,
so on and so forth. Okay? So
and
this
then
is an example that
we
is,
plot.
from our understanding, relatively easy
We plot
to
f of
produce math
x plus
questions with
k
Wiley Squeezy.
and plot
Okay?
all x plus k.
And then just to finish,
if
I'd
you
like to show you some
that's obviously creating
graphics
polynomials
with
that
this.
are polynomials that are very
So
similar, but
we
that's
are creating this time. I'm going
you
to
can see three polynomials now in my screen. So they are quite
I
similar.
guess you can see it
One is a
before,
good one and the
so
other
we
one
can
is
see
not.
how it works
It
before
is very
seeing
similar
how it is done. So here you have polynomial whatever has root minus 4 and 5, which is a form, which is of the form corresponds to the graphic. And you have three different graphics that are more or less the same. But if you are a mathematician, you will see that the right answer is the first one. And then,
so it's
and
modify
and probably right
by a column.
Okay.
So well, that's
oh, so it's correct. That's so I was correct. Yeah.
And that was weird.
Okay. Obviously, it's the same thing. Every time you go there, you get questions. I want to show you how it works. So again, polynomial P has groups A and B.
Just as,
and then for the graphics, we simply say choice 1 is something called plotter 1, choice 2 is plotter 2, and choice 3 is simply plotter 3. Okay, and when we go into the algorithm, always at the beginning.
Okay,
well,
we don't have much support for
so we have some random variables, some fancy creation of the polynomial.
We will improve our
and then we simply plot. We plot f of x, we plot f of x plus 2k, and plot f of x plus k.
It's not
well, if you that's obviously creating polynomials that are very similar, but they are simply different. Okay.
Okay. So
you can see the three polynomials now in my screen. So they are quite similar, but one is a good one and the others are wrong. It is very simple because it's from a mathematical point of view, it's very clear what you're doing here.
First of all,
so for a math teacher, I would say that for a math teacher to produce this content is not obvious, but it's far more obvious for a math teacher to check what this is doing once the algorithm is there, because it's very mathematically natural, I would say this way. Okay? So it's a feature to modify a possible block by a code. So, well, that's the idea. And that's what we were doing. Okay. So I think we've spent already 40 minutes with all this. I don't want to finish just after 1 hour because that's what happened the other day and it's a little bit strange. So I'll try. Awesome. 5-10 minutes before. Okay. ANOVA, can you describe ANOVA in better details? Well, it's going to be easier for me. Okay, ANOVA. We don't have much support for statistics now, but we have some support for statistics.
And
we will improve our support for statistics in the near future. I have to say that most of us in the company are mathematicians and not opposed to statistics, but it's not something that we've been working too much until now. But we'll be it's part of our plan, okay? But it's not there yet. Okay. So yes, let me just finish. Some little things.
Available for you.
Just to finish, I want to go to the pages where you can
share like
okay, so first of all, well, this Moodle site that I show you changes every night, so you can go inside there and with the solution. Anything you do will be removed at the end of the day, so you can go in very easily and change whatever you want. No problem, you can play with it. Okay. If you want to install the components,
you should just well. First of all, to show you as well that it's not that easy to create those questions because quite a lot of people around the world.
If you want to test all these at your own machine,
most of them, all of them.
The best point to start is wires.com/Moodle. Okay. Oh, sorry, that's wrong.
And
that's the right one.
I will also invite you to.
And if you need any help to test all these, you can contact our support team at support@wires.com. Okay.
Okay.
Sorry, again. Wrong again. It's not my
I
bad.
I was also reading at some point in the...
Okay, so record in English with double P. Okay. And now, just to finalize, I would like to show you what we call temple extraction. It's a collection of free content created with wide exclusives by our customer.
So very briefly, I would say that not only we have
support
for languages, but we have a very good collection.
So if you go here,
in case of
you'll see we have more than 5,000, almost 6,000 exercises created with wide exclusives available for you. So you can, most of them are Creative Commons free, share like free distribution license. And those have, so we have, let's say, more than 2,000 in Catalan. We are Barcelona based, that's the language used here.
But we are
more than 1,000 in English and almost 2,000 in Spanish. I was seeing someone from Venezuela, so you will find lots of questions here. This is just, well, first of all, to show that we have quite a lot of questions, to show you as well that it's not that difficult to create those questions, because quite a lot of people around the world have been creating them. Most of them, or all of them, without any direct contact with us, so they've been doing it themselves. It's relatively easy to make that work. And I would also invite you to contribute your questions if in the future you decide to use wireless tools and to use the quizzes solution. Okay. Then I was also reading at some point.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ramon. I think you have to come back. I don't know if I'm looking at this correctly. You did stop screen sharing, right?
I have to show you just in case.
No, I didn't.
Yeah, because I'm. Yeah, exactly. Because I can't find my. I mean, I have the pointer, and I can't get rid of the pointer until you stop screen sharing. Okay, now we're back. Yes, now we're back. All right. Thank you. Yeah, it kind of makes.
In case of Arabic.
Thank you. Thank you so much. I was hoping to see a little bit about the. I think we have a little bit of time on the general quizzes. You were showing mainly math quizzes. If you could show a little bit, because there are teachers here who are not math teachers, I think that would be interested in how it works and how valuable it is.
Every country has a different mathematical tradition, but we are supporting this kind of nice, super right-to-left mathematics here.
Randomization
okay.
of
so
questions and
other if you have any
but unfortunately
math
the randomization
of
questions in
movies
quite hard to manage and
you
many times
you can share these
it can break your neck. So what we have is quite a lot of customers
from what heard
creating
from
questions that
some
are
people
random.
In their countries
we have a
solution the best Arabic math normalization editor available right now.
With our math
okay.
But
so I think
we don't have any
the 15 minutes left.
Mathematical,
I would like to see if there are any questions
that
so that I can answer them.
From time to time, used by people that are not from mathematics to create random questions and so on. It's basically the same engine, but they are simply producing random questions because the default solution by Moodle is a little bit hard to use.
Any questions? Thank you, Ramon.
Sorry.
Are there any questions
no, I didn't stop.
From the participants here? Any questions? Are you planning and developing maybe more of the non-math, or are you going to still focus on the math? Any future developments that you're considering, Ramon?
Okay, yes. Yeah, so our roadmap is basically going to be the mathematics, but we are focusing
okay.
on
okay. I can
going to chemistry. So next natural step for us is chemistry. We have quite a lot of people asking about chemistry and so on, and they're at some point. And then
okay, I would say that basically the point here is that the main difference between So Ran Moodle has by default
seems to be moving
randomization of questions and other things. But unfortunately, the randomization of questions in Moodle is quite hard to manage, and many times it can break your nerves. So what we have is quite a lot of customers or users creating questions that are random with our solution that are not math questions, but are produced with our math engine. But we don't have any specific, let's say, non-mathematical development. It simply just that our tool is from time to time used by people that are not from mathematics. To
he developed some really, really great applications for Moodle. One of them is Poodle, is just a video audio, video, and other things that are just amazing. So yeah, that's Justin. Yes.
Okay, sorry. In any case, we will move with, because we have a lot of Moodle users, as I said. And one of the important things, the important reasons why Moodle decided to move to Atto was basically accessibility, and that's something that
yes.
I didn't show very
yes.
much.
So
our solution,
let's say our
obviously good for accessibility.
Our roadmap is basically going to be the mathematics, but we are focusing on going to chemistry. So next natural step for us is chemistry. We have quite a lot of people asking about chemistry and so on, and they're at some point. And then also as well as I can see that Justin is asking the reasonable question now. So since Moodle seems to be moving.
Any other questions or comments that you'd like to refer to
decision,
Ramon?
So it's almost there, the decision, I guess.
You can get in touch with Ramon at any time. Wyrus is out there. Wyrus.org. It's org, isn't it?
.com.
Sorry. I thought because it's open source, it would be org. Okay.
So, yes, that's the idea. It's important to say that from what I heard from Martin Dugamas,
what is our not open source solution? Our solutions are commercial solutions.
Sorry, I don't understand this bottle guy. No problem.
Using it extensively. So one teacher using it, it's for free, and we have like a formal limit of 1,000 images or 1,000 calculations per year to use the editor. And to use the quiz system.
Okay.
But
so just
it's never been
decided where we could go. Okay, sorry. Then in any case, we will move with
Moodle,
because we have a lot of Moodle users, as I said.
And
one of the important things, the important reasons why Moodle decided to move to Atto was basically accessibility. And that's something that I didn't show very much. Our solution is obviously good for accessibility in terms of it's always better to have a Java applet than, so it's always better to have a JavaScript solution than a Java applet in terms of accessibility. But we're also accessible text for those math formulas everywhere. So I think that we are in the same bandwidth as Moodle, focusing on accessibility and other things that are
Joomla.
Around.
Also with Joomla?
Yes, we have been using Joomla with Drupal with many, many tools. And it's something, if you want to see like shortly, you can check it. I'm putting this link here. You can check it there. I'm horrible today. I'm missing all links that I checked. Yeah. It's incredible. Okay.
No,
so,
that's fine.
So we haven't used with many, many open source solutions. And
no,
understand
the, so that's something I heard you said the other day. What is our not open source solutions? Our solutions are commercial solutions, but we offer them for free in certain scenarios. Those scenarios are basically a school using it not very intensively. So one teacher using it, it's
yeah,
for free,
right. I think Justin may be interested
like
in your plan. I'm not sure there, but
amazing.
It's amazing because it is important. We do have to make a living
to
have the two, open and commercial.
We, We
So,
are very
yes, he
willing to
is. Okay, so
open to
you
our
may hear
platform,
from
but we are also
Justin
working with commercial
very,
platform.
very soon. Anyways,
And
wires are
unfortunately,
amazing. Wires are
due to
amazing. Their
very
support is
frequently have the same
incredible.
question, we don't have plans to
I'm
go
really
open
happy and I'm looking
source.
forward to
We
more
believe it doesn't
developments,
make
Ramon.
sense in our
So,
model, but
thank you, and
we are
thank
very
you for
friendly to the
joining
open
us.
source community,
Ramon,
and
you're
I think
currently the
we've been
CEO, am I
doing our job
correct?
there.
Yes,
The open source
that's, well, that's a
community
formality since we're on
come up with a JavaScript
the
editor, editor, so
that's
we
my
have it
title.
here,
Yeah, you're
and
very
we're happy to
modest, I
cooperate
know,
with the
but
community.
you should
We
get
have a lot of
credit for what
experience
you do, and I
working
think
with
that's very
Google
commendable. Tom has added, Tom is from
people
Venezuela, he's
and
originally
also Sakai
from the
people and others.
UK. He's added
Well,
a link where we can continue the
yes, we
discussions,
have
okay,
linkages in
if people
Joomla
have
with
questions, you're invited
many,
to
many
go
tools.
in there. Ramon, I think you
And
were there last
well,
time
it's
too, if I'm not
something if you
mistaken,
want to see
that we
like
created a new
shortly,
class,
you can check it.
so a new
I'm putting this
session.
link here. You can
So
check it
thank
there.
you. Thank you
Okay,
so much, everybody.
I'm
Thank you
going
for
to do.
joining us.
So I'm
We're going to have
using
another
old
session
link that
very
I think
soon. It's going to be
it's internet.
super,
Okay.
super different
So
from this one,
we have
but it's
integrated with
about
many open
e-learning,
source
and I
solutions,
think that
and we
you'll find
understand
it quite interesting.
and we really
So
understand,
thank you,
we fully understand
Ramon,
the advantage of
and
open
thank
source,
you,
and of
everyone.
course
Thank
we'll
you,
follow up on it
Justin,
here
for joining
as
us
possible
this late
for
time.
us
I think it's
to be
late
here. The team now is
in
like eight
Japan.
people here at
Thank
Wires.
you. Thank you so much. Bye for now,
So we
everybody.
need
See you
to balance
later.
this
Thank you.
open source and commercial world, because otherwise it doesn't pay the bill for us.